Our life is an example for others. Our life is meant to be lived in such a way that it's an inspiration for others. It's an example, as an example for others to follow. Paul writes to Timothy in 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 12, and he says, "Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, in purity." So the last three things that he says is, be an example in spirit. Out of the innermost being, be an example. Out of the motives of your heart, be example. Why do you do what you do? You know, we could be doing many noble things, many good things, but what is the motive behind doing even those good or noble things? Paul writes about a time in the Philippian church, and he says, in Philippi, he writes to them and he says, you know, some preach Christ and their motive is selfish ambition, and they preach Christ out of envy and strife. So even a good thing like ministry, we need to check our motives. You know, why is it that we do what we do? So Paul writes and he says, be an example in spirit. Why do we do what we do? And we are exhorted to be examples even in our motives. Then the other thing that he says is, be an example to the believers in faith. You know, we are called to live by faith, and we are called to live a life that is consistent with what we believe. And Paul writes and he says, be an example in faith. You know, our life of faith can inspire others. Our life of believing God for who He is can actually inspire others. Just look at the life of Abraham. Abraham lived a life of faith, and after so many years, after thousands of years, here we are reading about Abraham, the kind of life that he lived, and we are inspired by his life of faith, and we study how he lived that life of faith, and so on. So your life, my life, can be an inspiration to others. Our life of faith, a faith in God, can be an inspiration to others. Our faith in the Word of God can be an inspiration to others. So Paul writes to Timothy and he says, your life of faith, let it be an example. Your faith in God, your faith in His Word. And the third thing is, the last thing that Paul writes is, be an example to the believers in purity. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 8, we see the Lord Jesus saying, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So purity and holiness is a prerequisite for us to experience God, to see God. So purity in our deeds, in our actions, of course, it's something that we can strive towards, and it's something that's easily done because you know, our actions are visible. Purity in our speech, that is also something that we need to, you know, strive towards and be consistent in. And that is also something which is achievable because it is audible. Our speech is audible, so people are listening. So our actions, it's visible. Our speech, it's audible. But purity in our thoughts, purity in our meditations, purity in what we think about, now that's something which only you and I know, and God knows, of course. So we are called to be pure. We are called to have purity in our speech, in our actions, and even in our thoughts. So we can be an example to the believer in purity. And as we do that, we can inspire people's lives, our lives. For some people, the life that we live is the only Bible that they will ever read. So our life can be an inspiration to others. Our life can actually draw people closer to God. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that that you use our lives to draw people to you. And I pray that our lives will be an inspiration to others. Our lives will be examples for others to follow. And I pray that in spirit, in our motives of our heart, and also in purity, in speech, in everything, God, I pray that our lives will be an example to others to follow, for others to follow. We thank you. We give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.